Hello. Back in 2011, I did a video of some of my favourite Felixstowe eyesores. And I thought as 18 months has gone by, I'd go back and have a look at some of them and see what's changed. Sadly, many of the eyesores that I looked at back in 2011 were actually on the seafront. Of course, Felixstowe is very much a seaside town, so it's not very good for business if the seafront is looking scruffy. So what I've decided is to go back to some of the seafront sites I looked at 18 months ago and see what's changed. And here's what I found. And here we are 18 months ago at the first site I want to look at today, which is the remains of the Herman de Stern convalescent home. There's quite a difference, as you can see. Bloor Homes have started to build their long-awaited estate called Martello Place. And here's a time-lapse view over a few months of these houses going up. And in a couple of years, the site will look, hopefully, something like this. Time will tell just what the impact of the new housing will actually be on the appearance of the South Seafront. But once the housing is finished, the remaining open land should be landscaped. An area of land which looked, frankly, pretty rough for a long time will hopefully be transformed. Along Sea Road a little way, we come to the listed towers of Mannings. In 2011, I lamented at how scruffy it was. And of course, there was the ghastly pink paint. But Mannings have been active with the paint pot since and have done a more contemporary pastel paint job. Things are looking up. But of course, as we go down to the end of Sea Road, what do we find? Oh dear, things are very much the same. The derelict area by the leisure centre is still there and looking just a little bit more tatty. And of course, there's the pier. 18 months ago, the landward side had been given a coat of paint and it was looking quite nice. But of course, as you look down to the other end of the pier, it's derelict. And it's very sad because it used to be the third longest pier in Britain. The pier itself was finished in 1903. It was the third longest pier in Britain and it was over 800 metres long. And there was a tramway out to the end where Bell steamers would bring people in and out of the resort on their boats. Later on, facilities were put in on the landward end. The use of the pier as a steamer jetty had declined by the Second World War, and all but a 136 metre length was blown up during the war to deter possible invaders. After the war, the present concrete amusement arcade was built, but the seaward part fell into disrepair and ended up in the unsafe mess it is today. But things are on the move here too. The pier owners have recently got planning permission to knock it all down and build this new entertainment complex, much bigger than the present pier, and already hailed by some local politicians as a great new asset to the town. That's of course if it ever goes ahead in this economic climate. It isn't very good news for the remains of the model yacht pond, as to build the pier, the contractors need a large site to store plant and materials, and it's perfectly situated for it. Once the pier is finished, the site will then become an extension to the existing car park. A good result? I'm not sure. Many people want some kind of visitor attraction back here, but if the new pier is going to attract visitors, then I guess more parking space is going to be a must. Watch this space. This is a story about redemption. Sites that were once part of a thriving resort but have become run down and scruffy are hopefully soon going to be transformed because somebody has been prepared to put down money in order to put them back into beneficial use. Redemption is a term that means spending to restore something that's become degraded or lost. To get these rundown sites to look their best again hasn't just required champions for their cause, but has cost or is going to cost somebody quite a lot of money. Whether that's expensive seafront houses or a new pier, it's going to cost. We also use the term redemption for buying back something pawned or mortgaged. If house buyers don't keep the mortgage payments up, then the property becomes forfeit. And then there's another idea of redemption: shopping coupons. We use the coupon to redeem items we get free or with money off. We benefit from redeeming items because somebody else has paid. Redemption is a word often used by Christians. It embraces all the ideas which I just gave you. Christians talk about the death of Jesus as being redemptive, a transaction that cost him his life. So just what or who was being redeemed? Well, the cost of his life was the redemption value of the human race. So why did the human race need redeeming? Because it had decided to go its own way and do its own thing, not to recognize God, not to seek him, to turn its back on God. And that's much how it is for people in our own society today. Just to listen to the news is depressing. We hear of all sorts of problems, economic, political, or whatever. We hear of the inhumanity of people to one another. The thing that both saddens and angers me, in almost equal measure, is how people use the name of God to excuse prejudice, persecution, or atrocities on others. Yet look in the Bible and we see God is different. He's a God of love that desires to bless rather than harm. It was going to cost to redeem people from the wreckage they create. And that was by God himself becoming a human being, Jesus, and taking that cost himself. And that was when he died on the cross. For those that trust and follow Jesus, the Bible describes them in this way: for he has rescued us from the kingdom of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his dear Son, who purchased our freedom and forgave our sins. I said in my last video on this subject that God wants to transform people's lives. He wants them to experience the beauty of life that he always intended for people. He made that possible by an act of redemption, the death of Jesus. We saw from our seafront sites that the beauty or otherwise of what ends up is going to depend on what the developers decide to actually build. It's the same with us. God wants us to come into the benefit of knowing him, but in the end it's our decision whether we accept what God has done for us and whether we decide to follow Jesus. Well, thanks for listening, and may God bless you.